Hey everyone, happy day to you. Welcome back to another episode of Hidden Folks, episode 9, I believe it is. Welcome back to another episode. Like I said, I think it's been a while since I've uploaded the last episode, and I am so sorry, guys. It has been a rough month of January. Been very, very sick. Migraines left and right. I'm so sick of it. I'm so tired. And this game is not helping. But in the last episode, I was having some major issues. I couldn't even think. We are definitely playing a hard level here, and we're playing in the city. And in the city, which we're getting ready to jump into right now, I was having issues trying to find one item in particular. This dumb, stupid Dorito rock. But before we get into it, there was a lot of things in here that I couldn't find. I couldn't find a lot of stuff. However, we did manage to find things by accident. A lot of stuff that we found by accident. That monkey there and the boss lady and all that kind of stuff. We found a whole bunch of stuff. However, we will be cheating this episode. Okay? Because this whole city, just by looking at it, gives me an anxiety of a lifetime. And I will be just kind of... I mean, look at this. I mean, this right here enough is actually making my head hurt just looking at it. So we will be cheating this episode. I am so sorry. However, I will only cheat on something that I really cannot find. And right now, what I was having issues with is this rock. This Dorito-shaped rock. Okay? But first, let me go back to this guy. Charles Baudelaire. Baudelaire here was giving me some issues. And I don't know where he is. So I have it pulled up here on my phone of where Charles is. Let's see here. Based on what this says, Charles... Oh, I feel so stupid reading this. Oh, wow. So basically, I was staring right at the stupid fool. Apparently, he's right here. Wait a minute. Charles is standing in front of the game museum. So, the game museum... Why would he be in front of the game museum? That's where he is. Look at there. Would you look at that? So, in front of the game museum, he's down here where the art stuff is. There he is. Well, no, gaming is an art, so that's right. That's actually right. But I didn't know that was there. Oh, when you're commentating and you're trying to look and think at the same time, it really is very hard. It's very, very hard. What's up in here? I want to see everything. But you guys are not important, so never mind. And so this Dorito rock. Now, based on this particular hint that I'm reading here, this Dorito rock was in... It says here that this particular Dorito rock, because I'm going to call it that, fell from space. But it doesn't tell you exactly where the rock fell. It just said it fell. And in this big old map and in all this city, it could have fallen anywhere. Where? I'm thinking it fell from space up here and fallen this building up here, because it's the tallest one in the whole game, or in this level. And it could have fallen anywhere. But guess where it fell? So based on this, that rock fell from space and it fell down here. In this bottom right corner into this building, somewhere in here. Somewhere. Right here. I'm looking right at it. This is where it fell. You see where I'm moving my mouse and in the center of your screen? This is where it is. It fell from space. And judging from what I'm looking at, it fell from space. It went through the roof here. It went through this floor. It went through this floor. It went through this floor past the Christmas tree and hit this person right here. What in the world? That's stupid. That right there, that's dumb. All right, let's just skip on ahead. And let's just now try to figure out the rest of the stuff, you know, by hand without cheating, okay? All right. I'm glad those two are out the way, because those two frustrated me. They really did. So Melly. Melly has a melon party. Melly has a melon party in his hotel room. A melon party is a party with a lot of melons and jazz. Okay, so basically he's having a fruit party, and I cannot remember why I saw those watermelons. I had seen those watermelons. So he's having a melon party with a bunch of watermelons. Phone is blowing up. You know what? I have been trying to record all day today, and it has been just about It's been just about, almost impossible. I mean, it's about to drive me nuts today. You know, the one day when you feel inspired to bring some great content to you all and just, you know, really bring it to you. And that's when people and things, outside forces, just try to mess you up. And it gets on my nerves. I tell you what. 1 second. Hold on. I tell you what, man. I can't take this no more. It has been a day. My phone hasn't blown up like this. And Lord knows I can't tell you when. All day it's been ringing. Melly has a melon party in his hotel room. A melon party is a party with a lot of melons and jazz. Okay, Melon. Let's see if we can find you. The hints are very, Oh, the clouds don't move back until... Oh, that was weird. What was I trying to say? All those phone calls have just got me so discombobulated that I don't know what I'm trying to say. Today is not the day for it. because the way the day has been going so far, I gotta look up all these lines because, and these clouds are really getting on my nerves today. Today is not the day for it. I just ain't got time for it today. I just really want a nice, smooth gameplay. You got a whole bunch of awards and junk in your house. And I really don't know. I'm raising all these blinds because this fool, for all I know, could be behind these blinds having this melon party. And I haven't had breakfast today in real life. I've been sick all night. I'm just tired, okay? I'm just tired. I'm tired and frustrated. And I just want a smooth gameplay today. And for some reason, it ain't happening. You got chickens in your house. Why do you have chickens in your house? I might be near this guy. Now, he's got something going on in this house. He's got plants and stuff going on. And there is indeed a party happening. Okay. Let me get out the old phone again. The one thing I'm trying to avoid is this phone. He was nowhere near where I was thinking he's. He's over here. He's over freaking here. So he's over here at the hotel. And he is right there. Oh, no, wait, not him. Wait. Where is he? Wait. Where is he at? Wait, hold on. What? There he is. Yeah, he's right there. Whoa. Yes, we'll stay here until we finish everything. What in the world? So he's at a hotel. All right. I'm just going to keep going. Nobody can sort mail like Paper Diver. Wait. Nobody can sort mail like Paper Diver can sort mail. What a woman. What a job. Paper Diver? So we need to find the mail place? There she is right there. Hidden Folks Mail. There she goes. There she is. I found you. Ugh. How many people we got left? A lot. Dadgummit. Alright, here we go. Next, Anchorwoman Angie is the public's favorite FTV news anchor. Oh, I think I remember where that FTV place was. The building has FTV on it, if I remember correctly. Ah, here we are. Alright, so this has a movie camera on it. What's her name again? Anchorwoman Angie. Is that her right there? No, that's not her. No. Cloud, I need you to go the other way. Huh. Okay, I guess you don't go the other way. Please go out the way. She ain't even in there anyway. Alright. Let's see here. She is somewhere. Is this Daily News? Is this her behind there? No. But we're in the right building. Is that her there? There she is. Okay, that makes me happy. That makes me feel better about this day. All right, Walker. What's all that breathing, boy? Calm down. Walker picked the slowest foot traffic line. Again. Ugh. Foot traffic line. Oh, that's got to be down here with all these people. So he's in this. The slowest one is this one. No, this one is the slowest one. So I gotta wait. I gotta look for him until he comes through. There he goes. That's him right there. What is that sound? It's like he is just straining to death on the toilet. I found him. Okay, cool. You know what? The faster we can get out of this level, the better, man. Because this is actually bringing me a headache. Okay, so Shopper Walid. Shopper Walid. had the bright idea to go shopping today. At the market? Okay, where's the market at? Here's the market. Shopping. He wanted to go shopping today. Now, this is the market. Would he be in it? In the market? Let's see. He might be hidden behind. That's him right there. Found your wallet. If you zoom in on it, you could say that the electrician, Lario M, that's not what that says, Laro M, really suffers from consequences of ad blockers. The best thing to do is just go around and just start moving ads out of the way, because that's he's behind one of them. All right, so I found out where he is. He's located at the flower shop. I just saw that flower shop. Where is that flower shop? He's at the flower shop, laying down on top of a billboard. That's where he's at. Is that him up there? Bling. Oh, well, I found whoever that was. I wasn't looking for them. Wait, what? Oh, wait a minute. Let me raise that back up. So if I zoom in really close on this billboard, I tell you that. Get me out of here. Get me out of here. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Stupid. We found everything in this dumb level. Oh my gosh. I liked it, and then I don't like this one. This is a level that this was hard. This was hard. Oh my goodness. I hope you guys enjoyed this level, because I surely didn't. But I hope you enjoyed this episode. I'm so sorry that I was so absent-minded with it. I had so many distractions today. Like I said, off the PC. It's almost like, I don't know what was going on. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, really, at my expense. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will see you guys, hopefully, in a whole new world in the next episode of Hidden Folks.